It's going to sound like a book, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
I know.
We got Preacher Stone. We're going to kick the afternoon off with a song about trying to do the right thing in the world, just kicking you right in the ass. This is called Good Man Down.
Right.
Afterwards and buy something. Hopefully we got the size and the design that you want. If not, we'll write it down and we'll get that some of it as soon as we can. And we don't have any green thongs already, so don't ask. It's not a possibility. But anyway, yeah, we sold out. We played the Baptist convention last week and sold slap out of all our underwear. But anyway, here's a song called Me and Mine.
We
some songs y'all know it a little bit, but right now we're going to let you dig on some of ours, but I'm going to warn you. Our shit is not politically correct, okay? People die in our songs. People about to get their ass whipped in our songs, okay? We call it the way we damn see it, all right? Here's another one. Send this out to our Uncle Jake. And somebody told me, said, man, I know your Uncle Jake. The funny shit is I don't have one. I just made him up. I just made him up, but this dude knows my Uncle Jake, okay? So just let you know that. See, because I can't use my relatives in songs. They all on probation. This right here is called Silence is Golden. Because we got a little drunk last night, I was going to be honest with you. And later today, we're going to do something special for you today. Today's my dad's birthday, by the way. And we rehearse over my dad's business. It's, you know, he loves it. I mean, every 79-year-old man needs a rock band to hang around with. So I'm going to call him a little later. We're going to wish him a happy birthday. I always... From wherever I am, I always call my parents and get people to sing a happy birthday. So y'all up here in a minute. That's going to happen. This little song called She Loves. This is on our Remedy CD that's available over here. Thank you. We played 3 or 4 songs that y'all don't know. Now we're going to play some country that you do know, but I'm going to warn you. It ain't going to be none of that. She makes my speakers go boom, boom shit. It ain't going to be that one song sung by that little fucker that looks like he just got out of fraternity wearing a t-shirt that's too tight, singing about that girl that he was trying to get with on the pickup truck on Friday night with the stain on his t-shirt. You know that one dude? You know that one dude that sounds like all them other dudes? That's a joke, people.
It looks like a werewolf.
I like my country music when country music singers was ugly and hooked on dope. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
When they was ugly and hooked on dope, that's how I like my country singers. I like Johnny Cash and Waylon Jennings and Willie Nelson. That's easy for you to say. Hell, I like little Jimmy Dickens. Little fucker about that high. Okay. He said tell the story, so I'm going to tell the story, okay? Y'all got a matinee show, so we're just going to be bullshitting today, I'm going to tell you that.
We're not even up yet.
I used to live in Nashville, Tennessee. I went to Nashville, Tennessee with a record deal. I did. I got a record deal in 1996, went to Nashville, Tennessee, and I got a paper route to go with that record deal because I was damn starving to death, okay?
Yeah.
My grandfather loved little Jimmy Dickens. He thought little Jimmy Dickens was the greatest person ever in the world. Little Jimmy Dickens was a drunk. He was a little drunk about that big. And he'd come out and he goes, where's my goddamn paper? And I love that. And he liked me because I threw it where he wanted it. He didn't want it in the driveway because that scuffed the bag, you see. He wanted it in the grass. So I put that little guy's paper in the grass. He's like, you're damn son, I love you, all right. And I thought he'd break my grandfather's heart. You know, little Jimmy Dickens was drunk every morning, but hell, that's just what you go with. Anyway, here's some good. We're dedicating this to the loving memory of my grandfather Riddle and little Jimmy Dickens.
Yeah.
every Saturday night. You can set your watch by it because it was always just right. We'd sit down in front of the television, me and my mom and dad and my grandpa and grandma, and watch Hee Haw. Anybody see Hee Haw? Roy was a pickin', Buck was a grinning, and them little girls was running around in short shorts making me think about sinning. I miss those days, because back then it was just fine. Mix rap and country and God knows what. Sometimes I just want to call up Nashville and go, Jesus Christ, stop. You know, where's that good music? The one that put on a tear to your eye. Now this voice just seemed to come down out of the heavens and it said, Ronnie, if you want to bring country music back to what it used to be, it's up to you, son. So I'm going to take this opportunity right now to write you a modern day country song the way it by God ought to be. You ready? Here it goes. I tried to hit her and then quit her. At least that's what she tweeted out on Twitter. I'm too embarrassed to say what she posted on my Facebook page. She called me childish on Instagram, so I sent a picture back and said, darling, I just don't give a damn. But I got her back. I found a woman just about half her age. And friends, I'll admit, it did sting me. It cut me to the core when I saw that picture of her on the internet. She is being a whore with a bunch of guys that I don't even know. And I found that Hallmark card where she said this guy was her king. She said, you're my king, your damn king. Friends, I've come to understand that love and marriage is a lot like a tornado in a Florida trailer park. It starts out with a lot of sucking and blowing, then you lose every fucking thing.
If we
train wreck this one, y'all not gonna throw much, okay? Here's some Florida rock and roll for you. We're working it out back here. This song's sung by one of my heroes. I'm gonna tell you a little story because it's a Friday, a Sunday afternoon night, and I'm gonna tell a story. A radio station in Oklahoma first played this, and when they did, they played one of our singles, Not Today, and when they asked me, they called and said they thought it was Molly Hatchet because I went, yep, in the beginning. He said, where'd you get that? I said, Danny Joe Brown's my hero. He said, you chose a good hero, son. Here's one for you. Here's some Florida rock for you.
I'm traveling yourself what you plan to be. We'll get with the time, we'll choose our destiny. Well, I'm traveling down this lonesome road. Feel like I'm dragging my head below. Yeah, I'm trying to turn my head away. But we're disaster every day.
Have a good time. There's nothing better to be in front of a bunch of people that like good music, that are good people. Cold beer, motorcycles on a Sunday afternoon. Can I get an amen? I'm missing mine right now. I'm going to have to go for a ride when I get home. This right here is called Save My Soul. Thank you.
coming around.